ya lo tiene.
Lizzie, ya lo tengo.
¿Lo agarraste?
Sí.
Thank you.
Look at David, when he was dethroned by his own people. His own that he loved, Absalom, had run him off the throne, and there his own trusted man was throwing rocks at him, and he walked up the hill and cried because he was rejected. 800 years later, the Son of David, Christ Jesus, rejected by the ones that he loved, wept over Jerusalem. It was Christ in David. Absalom had raised up and separated the army, causing revolution. David didn't even know what he was doing, walked up the same Mount of Olives there and looked down, weeping, a rejected king.
Storm's coming.
Now, we are living in a terrible time. We're living in a time of a great falling away. We know that. We are aware. Last evening, I was preaching on the subject of presuming down at the other church. People taking some kind of a something and just presuming they are Christians. And the word presume, as we explained last night, means to adventure without authority. And too many people are presuming today. Well, they say, I did such and such, I joined church, I was immersed in water, I presume I am a Christian. That won't work. As you can't presume once, you got to be sure you are.
Amen.
You got to really know that you are a Christian. So today, I feel in the face of...
You're right, babe?
Me? Yeah, I'm fine.
It's late.
Is it?
It's past midnight.
I'm just listening to what the prophet is saying.
Is something bothering you?
You remember in the scripture that says that day cannot come until there come a falling away first, or something like that?
Yes.
Have you ever thought of what that would be, or what would cause it?
No.
Me neither, really, until tonight. I just feel like something's fixing to happen.
Like what?
I don't know. But something that God is going to do, that is going to try our faith like it's never been tried before. And there may not be many still standing when it's over. Just a feeling.
Well, whatever comes our way, or God has to do, we will face it together.
Absolutely.
Are you staying up?
Just a little longer. I'm almost finished.
Okay. Good night. Love you.
Good night. Love you too.
Thank you.
Selena, I need your help, please.
Coming.
Morning, Brother Stan.
Good morning, Sister Sarah. God bless you. And to you too, little sister. God bless you, sisters.
God bless you, Brother Stan.
Oh, nice. How's our little sanctuary coming along?
It still looks like a garage to me.
Wally, how you doing, buddy?
Jules, get off. Get off.
You moving some furniture, huh?
No. I volunteered.
You did?
Yeah. This is the easiest way to hide from the pastor.
Oh. Why are you doing that?
Anyone that wasn't moving got stuck painting.
Oh. All right, well, that makes sense.
Wally, did you give me a hand?
All right, well, I'll leave you guys to it. Sister Julie, how you doing?
Great, Brother Stan. How about yourself?
Good. Nice to see you hanging up that picture in a little makeshift sanctuary. When a lot of message churches are taking it down. What a shame. Looking good, Princess. Sophia! Sophia, you in there?
Yes, brother, what is it?
Stan just walked past here. Did he say something to you?
No, I wasn't there. He must have been talking to you.
That's what I was afraid of. Are you getting any paint on the walls, or?
Yes, I am, as a matter of fact.
Okay. I was just asking.
I had a little accident, okay?
I see.
Don't judge me.
It's too late for that.
Oh, whatever. I hate it when you say that.
Here you go, ladies. For your cleaning pleasure, you'll make fine homemaker someday. Here you go, young man. I'm sorry. Excuse me.
It's okay. I know your eyesight's getting bad.
Listen, I'll have you know these babies are 20/20.
If they were, it's because you're so old, second sight has kicked in.
Hey, you know what? You need to learn to respect your elders.
Ooh, that one must have hit home.
Oh, please. Your remarks are so petty, I didn't even know you were there.
Ah, see? Even your memory's going.
Stan.
Sir Walter.
Question.
Answer. No, I'm just kidding. What you got?
Well, first of all, we found the entrance to the attic in the garage. I mean, sanctuary.
Nice. Well, there should be another access to the attic from the roof, too.
There is.
Now, your question?
Well, we're using this as a church house, right?
Correct.
So why did we put bars on all the windows?
It's easy. I don't want any of you to get away. No, I'm just kidding you. No, this isn't exactly the best of neighborhoods, Wally, so we put these bars up here to kind of a...
Stan, I think the young boys are going to need some more paint for the women's restroom. Here's your list.
You okay?
Yeah, just tired.
How are you doing?
I'm good. What's up?
Nothing. I just wanted to see you. So, how are you doing?
Mom, I'm fine. Why a third degree?
I haven't seen you all day. I just wanted to talk. You've been in here ever since you got home, and pardon me for wanting to know a little of what's going on in my son's life.
I'm fine. I'm just tired.
How is school coming along? Have you done all your homework?
I didn't have any.
What about your verse for the church choir song? Have you memorized that?
Mom, I don't want to do that.
But why not? You are so good at it.
I just don't. They need to find someone else.
But Wally...
Mom, please. I'm tired. I don't want to talk about it right now.
Okay, sweetie. I'll see you in the morning.
How are you, son?
Good, Dad.
Good. Wally? You know your mother loves you very much. You need to be a little bit more patient with her. It's disrespectful to her, and it's not pleasing to God when you get short with her like that. I know what you're going through, son. I'm not so naive or blind to understand that you're living at a very tough age.
Dad.
Wally, be quiet and listen for just a minute. You need to grow up enough to break out of this attitude that I'm too cruel to let anybody know that deep down inside that I really care and wish that I had control over everything. You need to give that to God, Wally. Because outside of that, you'll never be able to overcome anything.
Dad, I really don't want to talk about this right now.
Okay, Wally. I understand. I just hope that... Oh, never mind. Have you had your quiet time?
I haven't had time.
You're just too busy, son. Let me help you with that. No internet, no phone. Don't even reach for it until you've had your quiet time, okay?
Okay.
Good night, son. I love you.
Good night, Dad.
Brother Stan was telling me that the house is just about finished.
That's good. I know Brother Richard is relieved. He seems so stressed lately. I'm worried about him.
He'll be fine. I think losing the church was a major blow to him. But he's got the backing and the support of the people.
It's not just that, Martin. I feel the pastor's troubled about something. Something a lot deeper than finding a new building.
Sonia, the pastor always has something heavy on his mind. He's a pastor. He'll be fine. Don't make more of it than what it is.
How are you doing, sweetheart?
Hey, sweetheart.
I'm fine. Brother Richard didn't seem himself today.
See what I mean, Martin? It's not just me.
Did he say something to make you think that?
No, he just seemed down.
Well, all we can really do is just pray for him. We should be doing that anyways.
Sophia, what is wrong?
Nothing.
I'm not stupid. What is troubling you?
Mom, do you think I can go back to homeschooling?
Honey, why?
I just seem to do so much better.
Soph, your grades couldn't be more perfect. Besides, with having to help your dad with the second job, that would be impossible.
Mom, I'm old enough to stay home by myself.
We are not comfortable with that.
Mom, I'm not comfortable. Forget it.
Sweetheart, we are so proud of you. Brother Stan speaks so highly of your involvement in the church. You're a role model to the young people, and your grades couldn't be better.
They shouldn't look to me as a role model.
Sophia, we have every confidence that you can handle public schools. You don't know what sort of a light you can be there. Besides, the last thing we want is for you to be so sheltered that you're not ready to face what's out there. Eventually, you'll have to face the world in all its ugliness. We don't want you to be caught off guard.
Mom, I know you and Dad want me to be tough and rugged. And I know I should be able to stand my ground no matter what. But at the same time, don't you think God wants us to use a little wisdom in our decisions? Can a man hold fire in his bosom and not be burned? We should stay as far away from the world as we can. Not see how close we can get to it without messing up.
Sweetie, we've had this discussion before. Our decision has been made.
Good night, Mom.
Good night, sweetheart.
Hello. You've reached the Richards residence. I'm sorry, no one's available to take your call right at this time. If you'll leave your name and number, I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you.
Hello, Pastor. I was just giving you a call to see how you're doing. I know you mentioned you were tired earlier today, so I was just checking up on you. I just wanted to let you know that the little house should be done in time for the morning. So if you need anything, don't hesitate to give me a call. All right? God bless you. Bye-bye.
In light of everything that has transpired this past few months, I sort of feel like Israel must have felt while journeying into the wilderness. Now, this is just merely a temporary tent while we wait at the foot of this mountain until God says it's time to move again. Now, we take our signs from God, and where He wants us, that's where we want to be. Now, I can't thank you all enough for all the hard work and sacrifice that you've put in to make this the Lord's tabernacle, even if it be for a short time.
Take the picture, babe.
It's blurry.
That's because Al's in the picture.
Okay, got it.
Brothers, brothers, I'd like you to meet a dear brother. This is Brother Dennis Burton from Mexico.
Dennis, Al, nice to meet you.
Al, Brother Stan, nice to meet you.
Brother Nate.
Brother Pleasure. Nate, yes.
These brothers are my prayer warriors.
Ah, is that so?
Strange things happen when these men pray. I call them David's Mighty Three.
Well, I'll have to keep that in mind.
So you're from Mexico?
Yes, sir.
What part?
Nogales.
Really? I have a cousin that lives in Nogales.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Pedro Mendez. He used to pastor a small church there.
Pedro Mendez. I don't guess I have ever heard of him.
Where did you go to church?
Well, brothers, I would just go around to as many groups as I could. You know, just trying to be a support and a help to as many people as I can. Just anything to do to keep spreading that light.
I see.
I hear things are getting pretty bad down there.
Oh, it's bad, brother. They had several churches closed down because they refused to register with the government.
A brother was telling us that there are a few message churches down there that have registered.
Absolutely, brother. And thank God for them. We have to keep the doors open as long as possible to keep spreading that light.
My brother, didn't the prophet say that once you done that, you've done taken the mark of the beast?
Well, Brother Nate, we're keeping a close eye on the system. And the moment that happens, then we'll pull out. But until then, we must be as wise as serpents and as harmless as doves. Am I right?
I see.
Well, Brother Burton, have you thought any plans for lunch yet?
Brother, I haven't even thought that far yet.
Well, I know the perfect place, and it'll be my treat.
Oh, Brother Riches, you are too kind.
Oh, think nothing of it. You can ride with me.
All right. Well, it was nice meeting you guys.
Brother Dennis, yeah. God bless you. Nice meeting you.
I'm looking forward to some fine fellowship.
Enjoy your lunch.
Thank you.
You're binding yourself right up there to take the mark of the beast and don't even know it. Pulling it right over your eyes. Sure, it is a boycott. Then you say, I'll get out of it. And no, you won't. You're already in it. You're already marked. You're caught with a mark on you. No matter...
See? Says it right there. Can't wait till the last minute and pull out. You're already marked.
I wonder why the pastor didn't say anything. I don't know. Let's go eat.
Okay. Hey, you gonna share your fries with me, right?
You gotta be kidding me.
No,
I'm not going to. Get what? Your own fries.
That's cold. That's cold, man. I remember that.
Dude, I'm telling you, she's gorgeous.
Dude, I'm telling you, she doesn't like you.
It's meant to be, bro. I'm telling you, I had a dream about it.
You had a dream about the last four girls you liked. How's this one any different?
She just is. Man knows when the right one comes along. I have confidence in her like I've never had with any other girl. That speaks volumes, dude.
Jay, you've lost yourself somewhere, bro. Look, last time you tried to talk to her, you almost swallowed your apple. If I wouldn't have been there to save you, you wouldn't have died.
That was just a slight setback, bro. Not waiting for that one. But I shouldn't need your services again.
Wally, there she is.
Okay, calm down, kid.
She's coming over here.
Okay, well, you have confidence like never before, remember? Be yourself, dude.
I can't.
Hey, Wally. Brother Sten wanted me to ask if you still plan on singing that third verse in the choir song, because if so, we're practicing Thursday night.
Yeah, it's fine.
Okay, I'll tell him unless I see him first. KJ, awesome job on that song this morning. You're really getting good.
Thank you. And notice how I handled that?
I sure did. That's not all I noticed. Hey, Jay, I hate to be the one to break this to you, but you've got a huge booger in your nose. I'm just kidding, bro.
Julia, I am so sorry. I didn't mean that.
I hope not.
I forgot where I was. I hear it so much at school. I'm so sorry.
That's G-rated compared to what Sylvia and Karen say. I mean, have you seen their Facebook pages?
Oh my gosh.
You think they're parents now?
No way. Their parents are completely clueless. Their mom wouldn't even know how to sign in to Facebook.
It's sad. They'd be so shocked.
For real.
Their parents think they're such little angels. Parents are so clueless.
My mom wasn't clueless. She just didn't care.
I think they mean well, but I don't think they realize what it's like to be a young person today. Especially in school.
They think they do.
Yeah, like Brother Stan's Sunday school cliche. We've been there, and trust me, you don't want to go there.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Brother Stan. It's sure gonna be easy now.
I can't believe you all. You know Brother Stan loves the young people a whole lot more than your atheistic teachers. He's trying to help us the best way he knows, and I think he's doing a tremendous job.
I do too, Sophia. I'm just saying, I think we need a little more than the do's and don'ts sermons, that's all.
I have a test tomorrow. So dreading it. Hate public school.
Why, girl? Aside from school and work, I have no life.
I'd hate school too. If it weren't for Kevin.
Oh yeah, so how's that going?
He loves me. I mean, what's there not to love?
You are crazy, girl.
Hey, I hear you're talking to someone.
Yeah, Miss Modest. What's his name again? James.
Ooh, James.
We're just talking and just friends.
Sure. From what I hear, he wants to be a lot more than just friends.
Well, it ain't happening.
Why not? Is he ugly?
No, he's actually really cute.
Yeah, she's showing me pictures. He's pretty cute.
So, what's the problem?
He isn't a believer for one thing. I don't think my parents and I have ever had a Bible study without my dad pounding that into my head, how important that is.
Parents have Bible study with you?
Yeah. Is there something wrong with that?
No. No, I think that's great.
My parents have Bible study and pray with me every night.
Weren't you just complaining about them like 2 seconds ago?
Not complaining. I just think they sometimes fail to see what I'm going through.
I would have given anything if my parents would have done that with me. I never got the time of day. Did what I wanted because nobody cared anyway. I couldn't wait till I was 18 and could get out on my own. I haven't talked to my mom, or she hasn't talked to me anyways, in like a long time. Who cares if they don't understand you? At least they care for you.
So I'm reading a couple messages from what Brother Branham said. Dude. What is your problem?
I don't know, I have one. Can you help me with it?
Anyway, Brother Branham says, look, why don't you just act your age, please?
How I'm supposed to act my age? I ain't never been this age before.
Good point.
You know, he brings up a good point.
You guys are both crazy. You need to go outside and get your diapers changed is what you need to do.
Simmer down now. Self-control is a beautiful thing.
Yeah.
Watch your blood pressure, old man. You don't want to get your name in the paper. Oh.
This old man could put a whooping on both of you at the same time. You know I can do it.
Yeah.
Okay, you want me to break out these guns?
Talking about cat pistols? Aren't
they
cute?
I'll show you cat pistols, Princess. Caress that baby right there.
I feel like a mosquito bite doing it.
Oh, please, put some cream on it. Away.
You know we love you, man. Yeah, you're our favorite.
Yeah, I know. I can feel the love. Oh, look. Pastor must have tried to call. Must not have heard it ring with all the loud mouths. Try to call. And straight to voicemail. Poor guy's probably asleep. I'll try to reach him in the morning.
I think that's what I'm gonna do. Go home and hit the bed.
So, how do you like living by yourself?
Not good. I miss my family like crazy. For a good cause.
How's Marie's mom doing?
Pretty good. Ever since Marie showed up, she's doing better.
That's good.
Yeah.
I did not say that.
Yes, you
your
did.
Pants are on
you
fire,
said
you little liar.
That you liked her. When did I say that?
What are not you talking about? You, oh you just series two, volume 5, page 127, paragraph 8.
Wait, what are you doing?
Well, I was gonna take you home, but if you'd rather stay here, I can let you out or something.
Aren't you gonna take Sam and Jay home too?
Apparently not, because last time I saw them, they were running down the street chasing their dad, so...
Their dad left without them?
Yeah, didn't you know? Their dad's always leaving without them. That's why they're always looking out for him, so they don't get left behind.
Oh my gosh. Sorry, that's funny.
Oh, come on, baby. You can do this. Come on.
Come on, Lazarus.
Come on. Just start for me. Come
Lazarus,
on.
Lazarus, come forth.
Whoa. Yeah. That's a record.
Stupid.
You are just jealous, okay?
I miss you so much, son. Hello?
Tad.
Will? Oh my word. I was just thinking about you.
I was just thinking about you. So I thought I'd give you a call.
Oh, that's great, son. I miss you like crazy.
I miss you too, Dad. It's nuts out here.
So you learn anything in that college?
Yes. Computer science is teaching
me more than I could ever use in one lifetime. They're teaching me things that should be illegal.
It probably is.
Basically, anybody who understands these things can make any computer work to their benefit.
It's no wonder geeks are causing problems all over the world.
So you're a computer hacker?
Pretty much.
Just a professional one.
So they're treating you okay?
Dad, they treat you so nice. They make you feel like you're a part of their little society.
It'd be easy to forget that you're a Christian if you didn't have a real experience.
I can imagine.
Dad, this world is falling apart.
That's what the prophet said.
We have access to everything out here, Dad.
Sex.
Name it. It's yours for the taking.
How you doing, son?
I know you're praying for me. Let me put it like that.
Well, you better believe I am.
I can honestly say, by the grace of God, I've stood my ground.
Good for you, son.
It's not just a temptation. There are atheists crawling all over the campus.
They argue. To make fun. Even some of the teachers are atheists.
That's not surprising. Everyone's an atheist nowadays. Or at least they claim they are. Most of them don't even know the meaning of the word.
Dad, it's crazy. I tell them things Brother Branham said.
And they can't answer it. You can tell that they're used to arguing with nominals. But with the message, they don't know what to do with it.
That's true, son. This message has given us the devil's answer. No matter what level we're fighting on.
Dad, is something wrong?
I don't know, son. You're talking about a worldly atheist. I'm thinking of a much more dangerous atheist. A message atheist.
You mean like the Believe the Symbol groups?
No. They're not even in the equation. No, I'm talking about people that actually claim to believe the message. And yet they find fault. They claim mistakes. Even discredit the very messenger they claim to believe.
Dad, there's nothing really new in all that.
No. No, there's not, son, but there's something else.
Like what?
I don't know. I just feel like something's fixing to happen.
Dad, you're freaking me out.
It's freaking me out.
is about ready to explode, and everyone who's not rooted and grounded in their faith is going to be blown away.
I feel like God is fixing to test our faith like we've never been tested before.
Hello? Well, hi, babe. How's it going? Okay, sure, that'll be fine. Okay, talk to you later. Love you. Bye.
I fought a good fight. I finished the course, and I've kept the faith.
My eggs! My eggs, oh, come on, my eggs, baby!
Hello? Mom? Hi, how are you doing? Good. I was just looking at some old pictures of us and I thought I'd call and tell you that. No. No, I just called to talk. Oh. Okay. Bye, Mom.
If there was only one young person in the world that God could use, would it be you? Would God be able to trust you? To not go with the popular crowd, not cave into peer pressure, and lay down that ridiculous, I'm too cool to care attitude. Let me tell you something. Any dead fish can float downstream the way everything else is. But it takes a live fish to have the strength to swim upstream against the current. So could God count on you to be the one to make a stand? Against the raging current of pop culture, your friends at school, or the world of temptation that's out there waiting to destroy you? Or are you just a dead fish that floats downstream with everything else? We want to show ourselves great and strong and something that stands out from the common and boring. But in reality, if we just float along with the popular crowd and go with what's more cool or popular, we've proven ourselves, how can I say it, weak. We've proven ourselves nothing special at all. Why? Because we've made a public statement that we can only do what everyone else is doing. We haven't the courage or the ability to stand against the current. All we have done is what everyone else has done. What's so mighty or proud about that? Anyone can do that. That doesn't show power, it shows weakness. You think to be popular in school means to stand out. But really you don't. You just prove yourself to be one of the weak ones like the rest. But if you really want to stand out, it's because you're different and they know it. It's because they see that you don't fit in with the weak that tries to be like everyone else. But you fit in with the strong that is like no one else. Now you may say, Brother Stan, that's difficult to do. I know it is. That's exactly what I'm talking about. It's not for the weak. It's for the strong.
I know that, Brother Richards, but listen. If Brother Brenham really meant that, then what about your congregation, huh? What about your own situation? Do you have any idea how many people have been led astray because of those statements? Come on, brother, you know better than that.
But Dennis, I can't make that call.
You don't have to. It's as plain as the nose on your face. Listen to this. Do you really believe that Brother Brenham really knew all those things? You've got one statement here, the other one there? Come on, brother.
Yeah, Dennis, I know where you're coming from.
Of course you do.
Is it German?
So, my friends, are any of you weaklings going out to eat?
Don't throw the rest of us into your category, Jules.
I believe what he said. It confirmed a lot of things I already feel.
Guys, I'm just kidding. Give me a break. You all really know how to spoil a good moment, don't you?
See you guys around.
How's school going, Wally?
It's cool. What about you?
I hate it. I'm so sick of the language, the drugs, the drinking, the bad spirits. I feel like I have a hard enough time and then to deal with that, and my parents just don't get it.
I know the feeling.
Well, I'll pray for you if you pray for me.
Sounds good.
Good deal.
Please, everyone, be seated this morning. I will not be preaching this morning. I simply want to talk to you a few moments, and then I'm going to turn the service over to Brother Stan. Now, I don't want anyone to think that what I'm about to tell you is something new to me. It's been something I've been dealing with for some time now. I'm going to be brief and to the point. I feel the leading to take a certain direction in my ministry, but I'm gentleman enough to not ask you to follow me in that direction. So this is basically my farewell speech to you all. I will no longer be your pastor, and I'm moving on. Some things have come to my attention that I can no longer overlook, so I am publicly making a statement. I have led you wrong. I owe you an apology. So, let it be known that I no longer follow the so-called message of the hour, and I no longer believe William Branham to be a prophet of God. There's nothing to talk about, Stanford. It's in your hands now. The bank is expecting you.
You know, regardless of what you believe, I find it disgusting that you could just so easily walk away from the people you've shepherded for years.
I'm not walking away. I'm giving them to you.
What if I don't want them? Did you ever consider that no one would want to take your place? I'm not even qualified.
I know you, Stan. You could not leave them without a shepherd.
This doesn't make sense. Of all times, too, when the young people are struggling like never before, and then you pull something like this? Are you crazy? If you truly disbelieve the message, why do you care so much that they're looked after?
Because I still care for them.
The more I hear, the less sense it makes. If you truly think you're right in what you believe, why wouldn't you want to stay and correct your congregation from believing Brother Branham?
Like half the message preachers in America? Just to build my own kingdom? Not interested.
But you want to stay and correct them from such false doctrine as you now call it?
You know as well as I do why I can't stay.
No. Enlighten me.
You? Do you think I would stand a chance to convince the three of you of what I now believe?
As much chance as you have of making heaven.
See what I mean? I've not the years or the health for such a fight.
I don't know what to say.
Don't say anything.
So these are the church treasury reports? Okay. Guess I'll put them with the other documents that Brother... Richards gave me. I'll lock them up in my office at work. Until we can find a better secure place there at the meeting house. Al? Will you take the old Sunday school class for me?
Sure. Chilton family's taking it really hard. I don't think they'll be back.
I'm sure there'll be many that won't come back.
Sure, that's what it's meant to do. God right now is watching closely to see how many people believe this message only because Pastor Richards taught it. But it's an unprecedented opportunity to see how many people are following the message or merely their pastor. But don't think at a time like this that we're not exempt from having our faith tested. I mean, here's a man that we trusted with our souls, taught us the message for years, and now denies it's true because he thinks he's found fault in it? God has shaken the tree. It's meant for all the dead leaves to fall off. And they will fall off. But don't let the shaking make you think that you're falling. Good night.
Sweetheart, are you okay?
I don't know. I don't know anything anymore.
You know, Sophia, everything happens for a reason.
No, Mom. Not things like this. This is just... I feel like it's all a bad dream and I can't wake up.
Sweetie.
Mom, help me wake up. I want to wake up. You are the anchor.
How you doing, son? Are you confused about Brother Richards?
I don't think so. Just makes me think. Did he ever really have anything at all? Was there ever a time when he really believed? Was he just kidding himself all that time? All those years.
Son?
How does something like this happen, Dad? Why would God allow his servant, after all these years, to get so confused that he...
Wally, it's not God. Brother Richards made his choice, just as we all have to make our choice. The difference is that the elect of God have that seed germ that Brother Branham says controls them to the word. Outside of that, we'd all fall away.
How do we know that we have that? How do we know that someday we might not do the same thing?
A lot of people say they believe the message. What does that really mean? Well, a lot of times it just means they believe what someone has told them about the message. But they themselves have never really dug into the message to see what all's in it. So how can they say they believe it when they don't even know all that it says? There might be some things in there that they just can't swallow. It's like saying you love someone you don't know. How can you say you love them when you don't even know them? You don't know their personality, their habits, their hidden desires. All you're doing is taking them at face value, which really isn't saying much. It's like this apple. I could tell you all day long how sweet it is, how crisp it is, how refreshing it is. But no matter how much you believe my explanation of this apple, all you can do is just take my word for it. You'll never know for yourself until you take a bite and experience it for yourself. Once you do that, then you never have to take my word for it again, because now you know for yourself. Even if I was to deny what I said before, that wouldn't matter a bit to you, because now you know for yourself. You no longer have to go by my theology or experience any longer. And we've just had a very devastating tragedy hit this congregation. And it's understandable if our emotions are very surface right now. Trust me, I'm with you on that this morning. However, I want to say that I'm not going to allow myself or this church to dwell on the circumstances at hand, because no edification would come of it. If you're devastated by Brother Richard's recent act, it's understandable because of the love and respect we've had for him. But let me also say this. If his erroneous decision has shaken your faith in the message of William Marion Branham, then there's something wrong with your faith. We don't believe what we believe based on another man's theology or someone else's experience, but we base our entire faith on the author of the message, the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, Brother Branham talked about a very special place he called the Sacred Sands. And I would challenge everyone here this morning to go through the message and see what he said about the Sacred Sands. 1 week ago, a man stood behind this pulpit and made his declaration. This morning I'm making my own, and that is this: that if this entire planet backslides and I find that I am the only one who believes what I believe, Lord, let me stand toe to toe with the devil, look him right in the eye, and know exactly where I'm standing in Christ Jesus.
He's been struggling with these things for a while now.
He's a boy.
Exactly. He's got a lot of questions, and this thing with the pastor, well, it just isn't helping things right now.
I understand.
You know, I always knew his teenage years would be a learning experience for him. I just never knew how much they would be for me, too.
John, you're a good father. But God is a better one. Let's trust him. I'm gonna go talk to Wally, okay?
Precious, I knew I'd find you in here. How you doing?
So-so, I guess.
So-so. I don't know what to say to that. That doesn't sound like the Sophia I'm used to.
The Sophia you're used to is just trying to heal.
I know. I'm sorry.
It's okay. No, you're just trying to make me feel better. And I will. What Brother Stan said this morning made a lot of sense. I'm going to go study those sacred sands.
You do that. And I think the more you study them, you'll find that the sacred sands is a familiar place.
Yeah?
Yes, ma'am. It'll get you through this time. It's what's holding all of us. And you and I are standing in this place again, and you'll tell me how much those sacred sands mean to you.
You think?
Yeah. You gonna preach it to her, brother.
I don't believe in women preachers.
If you living it, sister, you preaching it.
Hey, Wally, how you doing, buddy?
Good. How are you?
Wonderful. I just wanted to let you know your dad's a little worried about you.
Why?
Because he loves you. Look, let me tell you something. It may seem like your dad is cut off from your affairs and the things you struggle with, but he's not. You want to know what his problem is? He's never had a teenager before. So he's learning just like you are. Okay? He may not have the answer to your every question. One thing he does have is a great deal of love for you. And right now you need a lot of that.
I know my dad loves me.
Then respect him.
I do.
Wally, don't play games with me. Do you think you're respecting your dad when you play that worldly music through your phone and computer? We wanted to mention the other things you play. Is that your idea of respect? Here your dad is doing everything he can to apply the token to the home. And there you are in the back room tearing it down. It's not respect, Wally. It's not honorable either.
Bless you, big brothers.
God bless you, Brother Salvador.
God bless you, brothers!
Hey, Sister Julia.
Yes, brother?
I'm surprised to see you out here by yourself. Don't you and your friends usually go out after service?
Yeah, usually, but everyone seems to be really down today, so I think I'm just gonna go home or something.
Would you find it inappropriate if I ask you for dinner?
Sure, that'd be fine.
Great. Where would you like to go? It's my treat.